and Merry Christmas. I almost died last night, but that is a story for another time. Right now, it's Diabolik Lovers time. So, if you're watching this on Christmas, Merry Christmas. If you're watching this on Kwanzaa, Happy Kwanzaa. And if you're watching this on Hanukkah, Happy Hanukkah. If you clicked this, then welcome to part 2 of Diabolik Lovers Explained. So, if you want to know more about that series, then you can watch my video, The Problem with Diabolik Lovers. Diabolik Lovers is originally a drama CD series that uses dummy head microphones, and it was adapted into an anime, an infamous, I would say, anime series that a lot of people don't particularly understand or want to understand, but I decided to reach out to people on Twitter and receive letters of why they might dislike or like the series. So in the first video, I received over, I think, like 80 or 100 letters. Unfortunately, I think because something happened to my Gmail account, I do not have those letters anymore. So I only have 3 more letters left. Let's get started on reading those letters. As a true Diabolik Lovers fan, I am writing my thoughts on the franchise while listening to character and OST songs and reminiscing on how and why the hell I have fallen into this addiction in the first place. My first experience with DL was my friend recommending me the anime. She knew I was always drawn to villain-like or unhinged characters, so she thought I would have a good time. She was right. Even though the anime series was questionable at best, I did enjoy every minute of it and watched both seasons multiple times. Later on, after discovering Otome games, I was told DL was actually based on a set of games, so I felt I really needed to experience the original content. I took the hit, bought the Grand Edition on Switch, purchased a Vita, and imported the rest of the games from various used sites. Impulse buying is a great choice. Well, let me tell you. I went on a massive binge and played the first 3 story-based games, Haunted Dark Bridal, More Blood, and Lost Eden in a month and a half. At first, I was shocked at how much more disturbing it was than the anime. I will never think about dartboards the same again, that's for sure. But even though it was shocking content, I loved it. I loved the thrill of not knowing what could happen. I loved that even though all the love interests were trash, that they still had variations in how they acted, and even if you did hit the best end in the game, it doesn't really mean it is a good situation in terms of the situation. I will say that I'm probably the only DL fan who isn't in it for the smutty mouth noises and tries to skip past them. My DL loving friends are so confused with this, especially since they dubbed me a pervert, but the whole experience just changed me. I have pretty much dropped any morals or standards I had for fictional content, and now I feel I am stronger because of it. In the end, I just tell people I am trash and I like my trash content. I feel DL is more of a game you play for an experience rather than for the nearly non-existent plot. That's a good point. I have found out a lot about my hidden fictional fetishes, that is for sure. I never thought I would want to experience getting chained up, whipped, and scolded by some butler-looking dude while playing a game. But here we are! My favorite characters ended up being Shu, I like how perverted he is. Cole, he is incredibly unstable and provided a thrilling experience, and Carla, I find him dangerously alluring. I don't think I will never not love DL, and I am always excited to see what they come out with next for the franchise, whether it be more drama CDs, another fan disc, or another season of the abandoned anime. Intermission time! So, it's not, I don't know if it's that apparent, but if you've seen some of my older videos, I love Kirby. So, I have a whole bunch of him by my side. And yeah, that's pretty much it. On to the next letter. Hey, I wanted to send my response promptly since Diabolik Lovers is one of my favorite games and I'm pretty much constantly rooting for it. I originally got into DL because of one of my good friends that I met in an Otome game Discord server. So a lot of people might not know this, but there are a lot of Discord servers for Otome game enthusiasts, I should say. And there is one person that I really enjoy their Discord server. Their name is Peach Otome. She's just a very nice person. I really like her energy. I'll put it on the screen here, or I will link it down in the description below because you gotta support other Otome game channels, right? They have been playing for over 10 years. Wow, that's a long time. Wow, my God, I feel old. And always had good things to say about it, so I wanted to give it a shot too. My favorite voice actor is Kimi no Rohe, of course. So when I saw Ko, I knew that I had to check that game out. And I pretty much immediately got the first and second games for my PS Vita after hearing a snippet of his performance as Ko. I really love the dark tone and themes of the game, and the use of dummy head mics is, in my opinion, a really lovely and distinguishing feature of Diabolik Lovers. Yeah, that's the one thing that I think they got. I mean, they have multiple things, like the music. But the one thing that they, like, got locked down is those dummy head mic things. I'm trying to figure out if why nobody else has done that. Maybe they have some type of, we're the only company that can do that. I have no idea. But someone needs to utilize that more than just reject. And I'm serious. I really wish that more games use the dummy head mics. The soundtrack is my favorite OST of all of the games I've played. Like I said, the music is very good. I often put it on in the background while I study or do other tasks. The voice cast tends to be a lot of my motivation for purchasing games. Legit. I understand that. And DL definitely has an all-star cast. I firmly believe that every seiyuu enjoyer has got to give Dial Lovers a try. My favorite character is obviously the one and only Mikamiko. I think he is a perfect blend of cute, sweet, and sadistic. Ko is definitely in my top 3 favorite Kimuro roles as well. Voice acting aside, Ko's character development is really beautiful. I cried multiple times through his route as he learned what love actually is and how he can show it to Yui. His afterstory in More Blood is probably my favorite afterstory that I've ever played. I could ramble about Ko for ages, but I will stop here. His route is absolutely a must play for those who love tragic backstories and sweet endings. Even his brute ending was incredibly sweet, although it did make me cry quite a bit. Thank you so much for this opportunity to gush about one of my favorite Otome games and characters. I'm looking forward to watching your video. Thank you very much if you waited. If you don't know this, I originally did not like Diabolik Lovers. I bought it, I was like, okay, I'm gonna play this game. I'm gonna see why so many of my friends like this game. I actually did get a favorite character out of this, and it is a character by the name of Azusa Mukami. Azusa stands, rise up! But I bought a whole bunch of drama CDs, and let me tell you, I listened to all of them. There was just another set for the Sakamaki Brothers that was just Do-S Super Vampire. And then after that, they made the so-called, not sequel, but they made a side story that was just focused on the Mukami Brothers. And they just named it More Blood, which is what the second season is called. And that's what the second season is based off of. Technically, if you're going to talk about the video game, More Blood is a fan disc and not a sequel. But in anime land, More Blood is the sequel to Diabolik Lovers. It's all kinds of confusing, but if you understood that, great. So I got them very cheap off of Amazon because nobody cares about him. And once again, all of my favorite characters are treated like shit. Okay, on to the next letter because we're trying to be happy throughout this video. This last letter is from a Diabolik Lovers enthusiast, MaiMaiOtome. She really, really, really loves Diabolik Lovers, and I can't even blame her because it is very nice to be very passionate and open about what you love. I got into Diabolik Lovers on mere coincidence. You see, I always liked reverse harem animes. I actually really don't know why, but I just went with it over the years. Then one day, I stumbled upon the Diabolik Lovers anime and fell in love in 2 minutes. And yes, these 2 minutes also included Ayato Sakamaki, my favorite character in Husbando since back in the days. Later, I also realized that it's all based on drama CDs and games and got pretty invested. Being into sadistic and mean characters was pretty much the main reason, I guess, but there is also other stuff I totally enjoy. Dummy head drama CDs and merchandise collecting. I see why people dislike Diabolik Lovers. The anime doesn't really stand out and the story doesn't even remotely catch up to the game's twisted lore. Thank you for reading. Thank you, Laura. So, how do you feel about the Diabolik Lovers series? I make stuff pretty infrequently, but if you've stuck around to watch me make all these things throughout this year and the other 2 years that I've been doing this, thank you. I really appreciate it. And I will most likely see you next year. Happy holidays, everybody. Come over here.
Okay, okay. All right.
Say hi.
Hello. You know.
Okay, bye.
Bye. I'll tell you social security.
Sammy, leave!